If you have ADHD or just struggle with productivity, you know that you need some sort of routine and schedule to stay on task. But how are you supposed to keep that up if every single day looks different for you because you travel or have other commitments in your life, like kids or something else? What are you supposed to do in those situations? In today's video, we're talking about how to stay productive even with giant blocks in the way, like having ADHD or literally no time. Today, I'm gonna show you a glimpse at how I plan my life, even with ADHD, to run as smoothly as possible so that I always stay on track and show up for things on time, which can sometimes be a problem with ADHD. Obviously, I am a huge fan of planners. I have probably way too many because every quarterly, semi-annual academic and annual planner that comes out is something that I just have to have. So I'm constantly switching between planners, but I think this helps me to stay engaged and on top of my schedule because I don't actually need a physical paper planner. Everything is planned out in my Google Calendar, and that allows me to always stay on time and on top of everything. But using a physical paper calendar not only brings me a lot of joy every day to use, but it also helps me to remember when things are coming up. When I write things down, I just tend to kind of remember them or have some sort of like snapshot of when they're happening. Even if my digital calendar fails me, I still have some sort of recollection that something's happening. Even with my physical and digital calendar in place, sometimes things still get missed. Let's talk about what that looks like on a monthly, weekly, and daily breakdown so that your life can feel less chaotic by sampling some of the things that I do. The first thing that gets on my calendar every single month are my group coaching program calls. I want to make sure that I always have enough time, whether it's in those group calls or if I have any upcoming one-on-one calls or intensives. If any of that's coming up, those always get on my calendar first. I should mention that even though I am putting these in my calendar first, I already have a lot of time blocked off every week for working on whatever I want to. So I put blocks of time where I just have free time and I can watch Netflix or I can work or I can spend time with my fiance or whatever. And it's really helpful to have these just kind of spacious periods so that you can have a little bit of rest, but also if you're really energized and fired up about something, you get time to work on it versus working on like a client project or letting other people's events take over your calendar. So Wednesdays are my content days. Like I'm recording this on a Wednesday, so I have Wednesday all blocked off just to create content. Thursdays are kind of an overflow day. So if I have any calls that couldn't be scheduled on Tuesday, I make sure that that gets on my calendar. Friday is just for having brunch with friends and working on whatever fun projects I want to. Saturday and Sunday, I take those days completely off. Mondays are my personal development day, so if I have to have like a therapy session or a massage or something like that, I try to schedule it for Monday just so I can ease back into my one day-ish work week. So Tuesdays, I go pretty hard. I'm on calls all day. Any kind of international clients, I usually talk to them that night. Tuesdays are also when I have my group coaching calls for my programs, and it's also when I update any kind of new products that we're putting in my shop. I've found that whether you work 7 days a week or 2 days a week, you're going to get about the same amount of work done because if you're only working 2 days a week really hard, you're resting really well in between those periods and working on things that light you up. So that carries that forward momentum, carries you into those 2 days so that you can just kind of float through them instead of feeling really bogged down and like pressured to get the work done. Versus when I used to work 7 days a week and, you know, 16-hour days, I still got the same amount of work done because I was so tired and burnt out that I just kept like reading the same sentences over and going over the same things over and over again. So it really isn't about how much time you work. It's just about focusing on the things that are going to move the needle the most. And to be honest, I only work about 2 days a week right now because I also have a team. And that was something I didn't have for a very long time. So if you're watching that and you're like, oh, I'll never get 2 days a week. For me, it started with Friday afternoons off, and then I would work all the other days of the week. And then I slowly started to take the weekends off, and then I started to take Mondays off. And now I'm kind of gradually getting down to this like 2 day work week. I don't meal plan. I don't like schedule gym time in. I know there's that saying, if it's not scheduled, it doesn't happen. But for me, what I've really been enjoying doing, especially now that we have some nicer weather as I'm recording this, I take my dog for a walk every single night for an hour, and that allows me to get about 3 miles in. So that's what I'm doing for exercise, and it's working out really well. I also listen to business courses and podcasts while I'm walking. And that really helps me just to stay really energized and excited about my work the next day. But also having that boundary when I get home, the podcast comes out and I am all eyes on my family, which right now is just a fiance and a dog. So kind of weird, feels weird to call it family, but you know what I mean. If you want to know like what the secret is to staying on track and not feeling so chaotic, it really isn't a daily routine. It's finding spaces in your daily life to create rituals and routines. For example, in the morning, I like to always have the same kind of ritual, and it's super simple. It's just me getting ready, putting makeup on, listening to some music or a really like fun podcast. I don't usually put business stuff on in the morning. And having a cup of coffee. If I'm being super ambitious, I might read a little bit, I might journal a little bit, but those things are optional. I don't force myself to go through those. And what I found is if you just kind of go through certain motions, it really patterns your brain to get ready for the day. It helps you have a sense of control, because what it means is that you can control that very small portion of your day. And so that kind of tricks yourself into thinking that your day is less chaotic, because you can go back and have those little rituals and resets anytime you want. So for example, if I'm having a really difficult day, like the other day, my car broke down as I was towing my horse in my horse trailer through the mountains of Colorado, like super stressful day. And when I came home, I just took a shower and that was like a total reset for me. So it was just like washing the day away. And that's like a little ritual I have. Like if a day is going really poorly or if I got some bad news, I just jump in the shower and just like pretend like it's washing away. If I'm having like just a really tough, like very back-to-back call day, I'll make sure that I'm always getting up, making myself a tea and using the bathroom in between every single call. So that's getting me up every hour. And that's really helpful just to get my blood moving again. And then also to give me something to look forward to, because I like to have lots of different varieties of tea and then I can pick a really cool one for the next time I get up. One thing that's been really helpful that my team has helped me to implement is something called a punch list. So every single week we're using ClickUp instead of Asana now to manage our projects and team and everything that's going on in my businesses. And what they've done is they've created a list for me and it's called a punch list. So what this looks like is I log into ClickUp and I click on it says Christina's punch list, and I'm able to see everything that I need to accomplish for the week. So it's things that they couldn't do themselves, they needed to task out to me. So for example, if I'm updating any products in my shop, or if I need to pay someone's invoice, or if I need to respond to some sort of press feature, those are all tasked out to me. It just feels really good to check these off the list, and it feels really awesome to have them all in one spot where I can just click the link that they are linked to and finish whatever form or invoice or whatever is on the other end of that. Of course, even if you don't have a team, you can create your own punch list. And this could look like something that is a running list in your physical planner. So when I did this for myself, I had post-it notes. I would get white post-it notes. I don't know, the colored ones just kind of drive me a little crazy unless I'm using them for some sort of color coding. But the white ones were really helpful because then if I didn't accomplish a certain task that day, I could move it to the next day or to the next week. That's kind of an example of how you could do a physical punch list instead of this digital one, but either one works. And honestly, the one that you use is the best one for you. It doesn't matter what I use if it's not going to work for you. One last thing that I've used over the years that has been a lifesaver, and I just reinstalled it after not having it for like 2 or 3 years, is an app called Rescue Time. So this runs in the background of all of my phone and computer and all my, you know, iOS devices. And what it does is it tracks what I am doing with my time. So it looks at what websites I'm visiting, what apps I'm using, how much screen time I have, but then also how that screen time is broken down. Is it productive? Am I working on business things? Is this like all Netflix? Like what's going on here? Rescue Time has been able to show me when I'm most productive. And I always thought it was like in the morning, because that's what everybody told me, like, oh, have these amazing mornings, wake up at 5 a.m. You're going to get so much done. The day's going to feel so much longer. Like that was total bullshit for me. And I found out that if I just work from like 1 to 4 in the afternoon, I'm actually the most productive, especially after a very slow morning where I could ease into my day. One thing you might find with ADHD is that every single day that you wake up is a little bit different. Some days I can take my medicine and go full steam ahead. Some days I take my medicine and I'm questioning whether I even took it. Some days I just don't feel like taking my medicine. So there's lots of different variables here. You don't need a full day routine to be successful. You just need these little tiny 5-minute rituals and routines that will help you to reset and stay on track and help you feel like you have control over your schedule. I hope this video helped you to see that you don't need a full day routine to be successful, that you can use these productivity tools, apps, and what I like to call micro routines or rituals that are going to help you get that control over your day and control over your schedule, no matter what's going on in your life. If you like this video, make sure you're subscribed, you like it, because next week we're going to have even more great content coming your way, and I can't wait to see you then. Bye, everyone.